After graduating from your university, you find a well-paid job and earn a large amount of money to buy a house. Have you ever had a fancy like this? However, your dream may not come true even if you earn a lot. Property developers mainly focus on building luxury housing for high-income groups to earn a high enough profit. Foreign investors consider buying and selling properties as an attractive investment. Both of them lead to skyrocketing property price. Dream of owning a house for home status seem to be impossible. You may discover the government always emphasizes on how to overcome the property problems in policy address. What if we find any obvious improvement of the problem? On one hand, the policy are not effective enough as the government always worry about the benefits of property developers and property owners. On the other hand, the policy are not really pointed to the problem, or even lead to other side effects. Our dream can only come true if the government could adopt a comprehensive housing policy of restricting private housing to Hong Kong citizens, as it is the best solution. That means a new development zone in Hong Kong should be divided to serve local residents, which are home status only. For the sake of preventing housing scabbing, all flats in the zone should also be designed within certain size limitations, and they should be all non-transferable. Then, you may query about why my solution is better than that of the government. One of the policies carried out by the government is advocating an increase of considerable supplies of public housing and home ownership scheme. It seems a good way as it can raise the supply of property, but is this really work without any drawbacks? Definitely not. It will only lead a more uneven resources allocation. Public housing is only targeted for those low-income groups. If the upper limit of the income is loosened so as to facilitate the home status, it will lengthen the waiting time of those who are really in need. Home ownership scheme is residential building subsidized by the government and allowed to inherit from generation to generation. If the heir is a home started and originally affordable to buy a house, he or she may choose to sell the home ownership house at a higher price to earn profit. It will indirectly further increase the property price. However, if part of the residential house could only provide for Hong Kong home status who is affordable at a normal marketing price, resources could be allocated appropriately and home status could have one more opportunity to buy a house. Raising stamp duties for foreign investors is also a policy addressed by the government. Undoubtedly, it is really effective to discourage those outside investor to invest in the property market and provide more supplies to our citizens. However, Hong Kong is an international city, which is well known as a free market, without any intervention. Imposing stamp duties equals to meddle in the free trade in the property market. However, if we only divide part of land for Hong Kong home status, it is the only way to separate two markets instead of any intervention. Investors could still enjoy free trade of property in the market, which can protect the reputation of Hong Kong. Some may worry that whether it would greatly damage the benefits of property developers and property owners. Firstly, the primary purpose of residential area is used for living instead of earning. It is unreasonable to consider their interest in expense of basic needs of our citizens. Secondly, as a rational enterprise, they will surely sell the property at a price above cost, even though they couldn't earn a significant profit like before. Most importantly, this policy is guaranteed the least effects, so the assets of property owners will not have a great drop immediately. It is only trying to decrease property pricing gradually through a long-time practice. Living is one of four essential requirements of our life. It should be the top priority of social issues to tackle by the government, particularly helping those home status. Besides increasing housing supply and imposing stamp duty, the government should do its utmost to get at the root. You will face the same problem in the foreseeable future very soon. What can you help? It is very easy. Just expressing more about your own opinion during consultation period is the most effective way.